bring this youngster from the wrong direction, which is they're going. So what we do that we bring them back to the normal direction, to the right path.
Okay.
To bring that Mr. back.
Okay.
This is very easy and very difficult. First of all, they have to have a confidence in the mosque leadership. Okay. So they have to relate themselves to the imams in the mosque. They have to respect the imam. The imam does not speak the language, does not know the culture, does not respect women and children, the youth will be upset all the time. But the first problem is with the mosque management, with the Muslim leadership management, is the first problem. So the Muslim leadership have to invest in youth. Have to empower youth and women and to make them a part of the leadership. Have also engage them, trust them and listen to them. This is the first point on the leadership of the Muslim society in this country or any country. Okay. Second thing is the parents at home. The parents at home sometimes force the girls to go to mosque, to pray, or to wear hijab by force, and sometimes beating, which is wrong. This will lead them to revenge, and to be isolated, and not to excel in the school and in the education. The parents have to understand that they were born in a different culture in Pakistan, but their children are born in a British culture, or European culture, or American culture. The culture is different, the language is different, and the community is different. It is something the parents have to realize, actually, how to treat their children in a different society. Third thing in the madrasa, in the mosque. Ignorant teacher using a stick will lead the children to run away and to have a bad feeling about the mosque as well. So this is the quality of the teacher, only the imam and the leadership in the mosque. So I'm going to get the right people there. Number four, actually also I'm talking still on the leadership, actually of the, to allow the youth to make their own groups and to let them to grow independently under the guidance. This is another challenge for the mosque leadership, for the Muslim leadership. For the youth at this time, they have got one or two objectives: to excel in education, to be the best in the school or the university, not to be bullied by other body or to be intimidated by others, to show the respect to the society, to the community, and not to become hot-headed, not to listen to hot-headed speeches, exciting speeches, not to take Islam as an image or as a figure, the color of dress, the length of the trouser, or the length of the jilbab, or the length of the beard, or the size of the shoes, or how difficult you make it for yourself by making halal haram or haram halal to become hard on yourself. No, Islam is for the community, building community, outreaching other communities. To tell the youth also not to live in ghettos, not to segregate themselves from the community and from other communities and from other faith groups. Tell them also, when they talk to others, not to be hard and harsh to them. Do it the best of manner, and not to try to force people to become like them or to behave like them. If they become role models, many people will follow them. But if they keep pushing people to listen, nobody will listen. To understand also, if you want to change the policy of any country, you have to get into the system. You have to get into the structure, the establishment. Without being there, nobody will listen to you. If you want to change the policy of a government, prepare yourself for the election to become a member of the parliament, or member of the House of Lords, or to become senior citizen, senior civil servant, or senior politician. It's no good to keep shouting at others while others are inside and you are outside. You have to find a way to get yourself into the system. This is something which you need to do. Actually, when you youth treat other youth, they don't become arrogant because they have learned more Quran than them, or more Hadith than them, or more Seerah and other subjects than them. No matter what you learn, there's somebody more knowledge than yourself sitting next to you, because he or she has different experience. To tell the youth also that there's a role of woman in the society. They have to engage the woman with them to work in a good manner. Each one should behave. Actually, the best to work together in Islamic societies, whether it's in the secondary school, or in the university, or in the mosque itself. To tell youth also to excel in sports. Sports is a very good exercise to consume the energy of youth. Also not to be upset by many incidents happen by foreign policy. Foreign policy could be a very dividing tool, but if you want to change the foreign policy, you have to, as I mentioned earlier on, you have to be a part of the system. You have to get into the system. You have to make a lobbying group. You have to make a pressure group. You have to write with the language that the people can understand and listen to you by. And this is another thing. Tell the youth to reach out to the non-Muslim community, to make them their friends, not their enemies, to build bridges with them, visit them without thinking that the visit is to convert them to Islam. No, visit them because they are human beings, they are good human beings, and they can help you at the time of ease and the time of hardship. If you do not do this homework as a youth, we cannot claim that people are ignoring us. So the responsibility is between the family at home, between the mosque and the Islamic leadership in the country, and between the youth as well, when they actually have to find the best way of training and educating themselves.